Hola amigos, this is Somvid and welcome back to CodePipe. We are designing e-commerce website using Django. Till now we have seen all of this in the backend design. Today we will design our inventory. So let's get started. Before coding, let me tell you what we are going to do. So if we see at inventory, we can see we have all categories here. We have minimum inventory where we will get the items that will be remaining. And then we have all inventory. And if we click on any of the minimum or all inventory, we will see their complete pages. And if we go back, check for these all categories, we have two categories. So let's go with anyone. We will get a list of all the subcategories that are available. And if we click on any of this subcategory, we will get the products. Since there are no products, so we are getting, oops, no products to show. So this is what we are going to do in this video. Let's see how we can do that. First of all, let's try to understand the relationship between our models. So category is the main model. Under category, there will be subcategories and each subcategory will have products. This is the main product where we will have name, category, subcategory relationship. There will be some features of this product. We will have a product ID. We will check if it is on sale or not. We will check if it is active or not. We will put one image so that we are able to see it in our inventory list. Each product will have a discount and offer. Next thing we need to understand is product variation. For that, Amazon can help us. So this is one of the Amazon blog where we will try to understand what is product variation. And if we scroll down, we will get a clear picture to understand how a variation works. So there is this main product. This is a parent product. Now this product can have two colors. This is a child product. And inside these child products, let's say blue will have two sizes, small, medium, large, and red will also have small, medium, large. So this is one of the variation and this is one of the variation of the same product, and they are distinguished with the size and color. Similarly, in our models we have defined colors and sizes, and we will be using product as a parent, color and sizes to make one variation. So let's say we have a product round neck t-shirt. So round neck t-shirt, red color, size medium will be one variation. Round neck t-shirt, color red, size large will be another variation. So we are using product, color and size to identify one variation. Hence this. So we are using a variation name which will be a combination of product, color and size. We will connect it to a product, making it a parent feature. Then each of these variation will have a separate color, size and 5 images like we see on Amazon and different websites. And each of the variation will have a price and stock, and also we can include rating here. We can remove this model because this is unnecessary. We are already using review in our rating model. In rating model we will have a variation for which we are trying to give the rating. We will have an integer which will be below 5. We have a user to connect. Using this we will get to see which user is giving what review. And finally review, which will be a text area. And then we have discount, deal and offer. In this particular video we will be focusing on category, subcategory, product, product variation. So let's see how we can make an inventory list. This is our seller dashboard. If we check for inventory, we can see the cards available on this page, but these are all just HTML pre-added cards. We will make help of the models we created in the last video and we will show them on this page. Let's go to our seller application, views.py. We will go to seller. We will go to views.py. Here we are looking for all inventory view, which is this one. Here we are just rendering the template. So I will provide context here. The context will look something like this, where we are providing the categories. That will be simple category.objects.all. Then we are providing minimum inventories, which will be product variation, where the stock is less than 10. So we are using a filter which is inbuilt from Django, stock underscore underscore LT, which means stock less than 10, and we are ordering it by stock. Then we are providing all inventory, which will be a simple query set of all the variations or all the objects of product variation. We can pass the context on render. Let's import all the models, product.models, import everything. Let's go to our template, which will be seller templates all inventory.html. Here we will use the context that we have provided. So this is a category card, we will put a for loop above this for cat in categories. Just below this card, we will end this for loop. On this main, we will say cat.name. For this image, remember in the last video, we have set up media. So that will help us to get this image also. We will put cat.image.url. So we have to make sure that we are using .url so that we are getting the source URL of this image. Let's delete this card. Let's check it on our browser. Refresh. Here the images are coincidentally not changing and I have used the same images. We are not getting any error, which means our for loop and the context is working. Let's use the context for our minimum and all inventory. One thing to keep in mind is that we are only using 4 cards here and remaining all the inventory we will see once we click on see all. So let's see how we can do that. On allinventory.html, we have seen for category. Now let's see for minimum inventory. Here we will be using for product in minimum inventories that we have passed on along the context. Here we are using for loop counter. Django provides for loop.counter, which keeps track on which loop we are currently on. So if the for loop is below 5, which means we will only show 4 cards. First we will show the image. We will check if the image is there. If the image is not there, we will provide a demo image, because not providing an image will cause an error. Then we have this product.stock. This will show what is the stock of the product. And keep in mind that we are using product variation object here. Then we are providing the product name. Then we are providing the category name. And we have edit and delete buttons, which we will see later. So this is for minimum inventory. Here is for all inventory. So we can see product in all inventories. And other things are basically same. The only difference is we are not providing the stock number, because this is not from the minimum inventory. So we can skip the stock. Let's refresh our page. Here we are not able to see any products because we have not added any product. So let's go to our admin and add some product and product variations. Let's add some product. Category men, subcategory, let's say round neck t-shirt. Gender male, name, let's say Hulk t-shirt. We are not keeping it on sale, it is active. Let's choose one image. Again in our static, we will choose one image. Let's save this. Let me add one for female category. Category woman, subcategory. We don't have any subcategory for women, so let's add one. Women name, let's say jeans. We take image. Let's save this. Gender female. We will keep it, let's say, slim jeans. Name of the product. We are keeping everything as it is. We are choosing one image. And for female, let's choose anyone. Let's save this. Here we can see we have modified our admin product page. So let me show you how. In our admin.py of products, we have used other models. We will use this line of codes to get a display list where we can get name, active or not, on sale or not. And this is get gender. This get gender is coming from models.py. Inside the product, we have this get gender, which will return get gender display. Basically, we are using M and F for male and female. By using this, we will get complete male and female. So this is how we are using model in our admin.py to give a display list. And same we are doing for the product variation also. We will add some product variations. So we'll go to product variation, add variation. I will select a product, which is Hulk t-shirt. Here we will not touch slug, item number and name, because we want it to generate itself. And I will show you how. We will select color. We don't have any color, so I will add one. Name of the color is black and the color code is 000000. Let's add one size also. For round neck t-shirt, let's say we have medium. Let's choose one image. Let's keep any price. Let's keep the stock above 11, so let's make it 12. Save it. Here we can see we have the product variation with item number 1. Name we have got. We have product, we have color, size, price and stock. So let me tell you how we are getting the item number, name and slug. In our product model.py, this is our product variation. Here if we come down, we have custom defined or overwritten the save. We are giving the self.item number as self.number, which is a method. And we have this method here. We will count if there are any product variation objects or not. If there are no objects, we will return the item number as 1. If there are some objects, we want to get the last object and make a plus 1 to the ID. So here we are doing this. We are getting the last object like this, and we are returning the ID of the last object plus 1. And for the slug, we are using slugify from Django utils text, which is here. And finally, we are calling the super.save. We have one variation here, so let me add some more variations. Now I have added some more variations. For t-shirt, I have added small, medium and large. For jeans, I have added 28, 30 and 32 black. Now let's go to our all inventory page and refresh. Now we can see we are getting cards for minimum inventory, which says 4 items and 6 items. Then we have all inventory. Now what we will do is, we will make a page where if we click on this, it will give us all the subcategories. So in our seller views.py, I will make a view which will give us all the subcategory list. The view will look something like this. We will be using generic.list view. It will help us getting the list of all the subcategories inside a category. So we will provide the model of subcategory. We will provide a template name which is not yet created. We will create it. Then we have context object name. And we have a method of query set. We will use keyword arguments of name, and this name will be passed through template from the all inventory page. We will see this in a moment, and we will return all the objects with the filter of category name we are providing. And in the getContext method, we are also providing a context of category, and this context we will be using to understand we are on which page. Now let's quickly make our template. So in seller, we will create a new file with the name subcategorylist.html. On this page, we just want to see subcategories of each category. So the HTML we are going to use is this. So let me explain you. On the top, we are extending it from seller base. We are giving it a title of category, which we are passing through the context, and subcategories. So it will be men subcategories or women subcategories. In the content block, again, we are giving the title of all the category subcategories, and then we are checking if a category has subcategories or not. If we have, we will go through a loop for each category. We will take out the image and we will take out the name. If there are no categories, we will just present no subcategories to show. So let's check on our web page. If we click on any of the category, we are getting the page for subcategories, and we are also getting the title as all men subcategories. We only have one subcategory, so we are getting that. If we check for women, let's click here. We are getting all women subcategories, and we have jeans here, which is the only subcategory in the women main category. Inside this back button, we are just using the URL to go to the main inventory page. At this point, we want to click on this and get the list of all the products that are under this subcategory. This will be one way to get all the products. Other ways are, if we go to inventory, we have this minimum inventory and we have all inventory. So we want to click on this see all button, and we want to see all the products that are minimum inventory to be displayed on the page. And same with this all inventory. If we click on see all, we should get all the products. The best way to do this is, we can make a single template and we can redirect this all inventory, minimum inventory and the subcategory to this page. So let's start with views.py. We will be creating 3 views. One will be redirecting from subcategory views and all the context of that view. Next will be minimum inventory and all the context of this inventory. And last, we have all inventory. So we will be creating 3 views in our views.py. Let me quickly add those views and I will walk you through it so that you will get a good understanding. So here are the views. First one, we have minimum inventory list view. We will be using a list view so that we are getting a list of all the product variation products. So we will provide model product variation, template name is inventory list. This will be common for all the 3 views. Then we are providing context object name products. This will be the same for all the views. Then in the extra context, we are providing something extra using which we will be able to identify if this is a minimum inventory, all inventory or subcategory inventory. So here I am providing minimum inventory. Along with that, I am also providing inventory type, which will be minimum. And we can use this in our inventorylist.html to identify which view we are taking, and we are also using paginate by, which means we only want 12 cards to show on the page at a time. If there are more than 12, it will be distributed among different pages. To get the query set of this, we are overriding the getQuerySet method, which will return product variation objects. We are filtering it with the stock less than 10, and we are ordering it by stock. Next is our all inventory list view. Model, template, context object name, paginate are all same. In the extra context, we are providing inventory type as all. And if we observe, we are providing the same context, but the value is different things. So we can use the same filter to identify which view we are getting. And since this is all inventory list view, so we will be getting all the objects of product variation. And at the last, we have all subcategory list view. Again, we are using list view. This is a little bit tricky, but not too hard. Let me try to explain it. We are getting the model, template name, context object name same. We are also paginating it by 12. For get query set, we are using keyword arguments. So when we are on the subcategory page, if we click on any of the subcategory, we are going to take primary key of that subcategory, and we will be using that to filter our product variation objects, as we can see here. So product is a direct child of product variation, and subcategory is a child of product, so we are using double underscore. If you are confused about this filter parameters, Django documentation provides a very well written answer for this. And since we are using keyword arguments, so it is easier to override the get context data instead of writing extra context. I will use the primary key from keyword arguments, and I will take the subcategory, and I will pass this subcategory with our inventory type and the category name as category name. So these are all the three views. Let's quickly make URLs for them, as we already have the template. So in URLs, I will paste the three URLs here, which is minimum inventory. We are using the view, and we are using the name minimum inventory. Same with all inventory, but in subcategory inventory, we are using the primary key, which will be the integer. Since we are using all inventory list view, which we have created new, we will delete this all inventory view. As we have deleted this URL, make sure that you are changing the URL to this name in all our HTML pages, otherwise we'll get an error. In our inventorylist.html, here I will change this for loop with this code. Let me explain you. So we are checking if we are getting any products or not. If we are getting any products, we will loop through each of them, and we will take out all the necessary information like image, product name, stock, etc. One thing to note here is we are making a if condition here for minimum inventory. If we are taking minimum inventory view, we want the stock to be shown, otherwise not. So this is for that. And at the end, we are saying if there are no products, we don't have any product to show. And remember, in our view, we have also provided pagination. For that, let me paste the HTML. This is the HTML for pagination. This is a simple pagination HTML, and we can directly get it from Django documentation page, and we don't have to change anything. Now coming to the top, which is the heading, we will also change this with this code. On the top, we are providing the heading, which is inventory type. And remember, every view is sending each of their inventory type. If it is minimum, we are sending minimum. If it is all, it is all. And if it is a subcategory, we are also sending a subcategory. So this will be our heading as per the view we are using. And there is this if else condition, which is used for go back button. And we will discuss about this in a moment. If we check our web page, if we go to inventory, here there is something wrong. We should be getting category and minimum inventory, all inventory. So let's go back to our urls.py and undelete the last URL we have deleted. But let's change the name here. This is the all inventory view, which is getting us the main page. So after changing this name on my templates, let's refresh our browser. And now we can see we are getting the proper page. So let me try to click on this see all button and see if we are getting all the products in minimum inventory. But make sure you are using the template URL tagging for minimum inventory view and link it to the href of this anchor tag. After that, if I click on this, we are getting the page with the minimum inventory. And we can see here we are also getting the page 1 of 1. As the number of cards is less than 12, so it will show page 1 of 1. Let's try for all inventory. See all. Here we can see we are getting name as all inventory and we are getting all the products that are available in our database. Now let me tell you about this go back button that we have in our HTML. So if we click on go back here, we will get to the main page of inventory. But if we are getting into the category and we are getting all the products from subcategory, first thing is we are getting all the products from the men round neck t-shirt inventory, which means our view is working correctly. Now coming to this go back button on minimum inventory and all inventory pages, this was going straight back to the main inventory page. But for this page, if we click on go back, it should go to the subcategory page. If we click here, we are getting on men subcategory. For this purpose, in our HTML page, we are using this if else condition. If we are going through the subcategory, we should be able to get to the subcategory list page. Else we will get to the inventory main page. So this is the significance of this if else statement. So this is how we can show inventory on our seller dashboard. I think this is a good point to conclude this video. In the next video, we will see how we can use this edit and delete buttons so that we can edit our product or maybe delete our product. So stay tuned for that. If you like the video, please give us a thumbs up. Leave a comment in the comment section. If you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button and push the notification bell so that you don't miss out any videos. We will meet very soon with a new video. Until then, this is Somvir taking your leave. Adios.